How's it going, guys? We've been fortunate enough to get a nice afternoon. As you can see, the sky is nice and blue now. So I thought I'd come out and make some chili and rice. I was going to sit down by the seafront, but the tide's coming in. It's still real windy, and you know, with the sound of the waves crashing, I don't know if you'd be able to hear me. So I'm going to go up to the forest. See if I can get a bit more shower, and I'll catch up with you then. I'll see you in a bit. It's always hard work getting up here, but I'm here now, so I'm gonna use the new Bushbox titanium pocket stove, so you'll get to see that for the first time. And yeah, just gonna use some Esbit fuel blocks to as the fire. So let's get set up. Can be a little awkward to snap together sometimes. Let's see if I can show you putting it together. So first you get your back and your two side. Then you get your ash pan on the bottom, that slots in there. Get the shower slot in there, here we go. And then you take your front. This I'll be slotting in the higher shelf today, so I can put my fuel tablet on there. And then you got your trivets that sit on the top. So yeah, at the moment it's still a bit tough to put together and take apart, but maybe over time it will get a bit easier. But once it's together, it's, you know, it's solid, it's not coming apart. and I'm just using my 16 centimeter Billy can, which is perfect size for cooking these. Well, you probably could get away with a slightly smaller one, but I find that one just right. Doesn't seem to matter where I go around here. I can't seem to get away from the wind. And still, can't find any level ground. So I've got about 32 ounces of water in here, which is just the right amount. I find the best way for these is just literally just slip the ends open a little bit, just so the steam and that can escape and it's not gonna explode on you. So I don't know if you saw my last video, but well, I've done the Spanish omelette. Yeah, I just got back from Spain. So it's kind of depressing. It's nice being back, but then you miss all the sunshine and the blue skies and, you know, people just sitting out by the beach at the coffee shop, just relaxing. And you come back here and everyone's wearing their coats and it's grey. Although today is nice. Sky is blue, which has only cleared off over like the last half hour, so I thought I'd come out and make the most of it. And then I gotta go back to work in a few days. I've just had about 3 weeks off, I think, so that's gonna be hard getting back into work and that. But it is what it is, I suppose. You gotta do what you gotta do. So I'm just gonna enjoy my last few days off before I get stuck back in again. I don't know if you guys have ever tried these Look What We Found meals, but I think they're awesome for like backpacking and camping and that. That's my favorite one, the old chili con carne. I think they're about what they range, but this one's about £1.60, so, and then I just buy the boil in the bag rice as well. But yeah, really handy and convenient. Then you just cook it in its little pack as it is with your rice. It takes about 10 minutes and you're good to go. Alright, this water's almost at boil now, so I'm just going to set these in. Leave it for about 10 or 15 minutes and then you should be good to go. it's been about 12 minutes and this is done. Let that drain off on there for a minute. The easiest way I find for these is to cut the top off and then just stick the rice in the bag, because then you ain't got any washing up. You just got the old water left that's in your billy can. There it is, chili con carne with rice. Friggin' awesome. Oh yeah. It's gotta be one of my favorite foods, chili. Rice. Yeah, so if you don't want to have to worry about washing bowls or plates up and that, I'd say that's the way to go. It's easy. There's no fuss, just stick them in the pot of water, let them cook and eat. Tell you what, I'm liking the Bushbox titanium stove as well, and I ain't gotta worry about my pathfinder bottle falling off it like if you saw the pot noodle fail video. That just all dumped over, so that's when I decided to get a new stove. You know, it's not the cheapest one, you can get cheap ones out there, but they are good quality. It was, I think, what did I pay, 40 quid, something like that for it. But they're a good brand, well made, and hopefully it will last me a long time. finish this up and then I'll catch up with you in a bit, right? Cheers. Alright guys, I'm packed away and ready to head off, so appreciate you watching and I'll catch you on the next one. See you later. I'll see if I can give you a sense of how steep this is, because on the camera it doesn't look like much at all. But I'll go down so you can see just how bad it is. Hopefully I won't fall on my ass, but we'll see. It's always a relief to get down from there. Blimey.